Welcome! Today we're answering the question, what is a bumblebee and how is it different from a honeybee? It's a bumblebee versus honeybee showdown. When you think of a bee, what's the first thing that comes to mind? Honey? A large hive? Beeswax? Let me know in the comments. Now I want you to picture a bee in your mind. What does it look like? I'll bet it's kind of big and fluffy and probably pretty cute. What if I told you that the big, fluffy, and cute bee is a bumblebee, but the bee that makes all the honey is a honeybee? At this point, you're probably asking, what's the difference between a honeybee and a bumblebee? Does it even matter? First off, all bees are insects. Their closest relatives are wasps and ants, and they all have 6 legs. Both bumblebees and honeybees belong to a group of insects called the corbiculate bees, or bees which have a pollen basket. Now, this is my new favorite thing. As they travel from flower to flower, corbiculate bees have a little pouch where they store the pollen that they collect. Think of it as a bee stopping off at the market to fill up a tiny messenger bag with groceries, and you're not far off. Now let's talk about the differences. Honeybees are smaller and thinner than bumblebees, and they have more of a defined segmentation between their head and their abdomen. They also have 2 sets of wings. They kind of look like wasps. Bumblebees, on the other hand, are classic bee. They're fluffier, larger, and you can't really see any divisions in their body. Bumblebees have 2 sets of wings too, but the back wings are smaller and attached to the front wings with little hooks, so it kind of looks like they only have 1 set. This is part of the reason for the myth that bumblebee flight somehow defies the laws of physics. It really doesn't. Both bees have stingers, which they use to defend themselves and their hive. However, unlike wasps and hornets, bees rarely sting unless they're provoked. In any event, avoiding agitating these animals is always a good strategy, as it is possible to have serious allergies to their stings. Honeybees are highly social insects. They build large hives and produce and store a lot of honey. Each honeybee hive can house up to 50,000 bees and can produce up to 200 pounds of honey a year. That's a lot of honey! Bumblebees also live in hives. However, their homes are much smaller, often housing only 250 individuals. Do bumblebees make honey? Not really. They do store pollen in little wax pots that look similar to the honeycombs you're used to. Along with nectar, that pollen is fed to developing larvae, or as I like to call them, the baby bees. If you've seen a honeybee, I'll bet it was the western honeybee, Apis mellifera, which was domesticated in Europe almost 10,000 years ago. The western honeybee has since spread all over the world and is responsible for the delicious honey that we buy at the grocery store. There's even honey that was buried for years with Egyptian mummies that's still fresh. The western honeybee is only one of about 7 honeybee species worldwide, but there are many wild species of bumblebee all over the world. Canada alone has over 40 species of native bumblebee. Because they've evolved alongside many of our native plants, they play a critical role in maintaining our ecosystems and actually many of our favorite crops. Now that we know some of the differences between honeybees and bumblebees, does it matter? Honeybees and bumblebees are both important pollinators, which means that when they fly around to flowers collecting pollen and nectar to eat, they also transfer pollen between these flowers, helping plants make seeds that will eventually grow into the next generation. Pollen is critical to the food we eat and most of the plants we love. In many ways, bumblebees are much better pollinators than honeybees, and they're particularly good at pollinating flowers where honeybees can't access the pollen. They do this by using their long tongue, called a proboscis, which can reach down into flowers and get at the sweet, sweet nectar and pollen inside. Bumblebees also do something called buzz pollination, where they hold onto a flower and buzz their wings rapidly to release tightly held pollen. This is especially important for plants like tomatoes and eggplants, where this type of pollination can increase yields by up to 30%. Both of these strategies means that bumblebees can pollinate way more plants than honeybees, and because of that, they're actually more valuable for their contributions to the food we eat, even though they don't directly produce any of it. Sadly, both bumblebees and honeybees are under threat, and bumblebees continue to decline across their historical ranges all over the world. So what's threatening the bees? There are 3 main threats to bumblebees worldwide. The first one is called habitat degradation. Bumblebees need lots of plants to forage on, like meadows and fields of flowers that bloom all summer, and they also need places to make hives and overwinter, like downed trees, long grass, and abandoned rodent hollows. Urbanization has eliminated most of these areas from our cities. However, there is research that if we plant lots of wildflowers in our garden, we can actually help bring back some of their native habitat into our cities, which will help bring back the bees. Second, places like golf courses, farms, and gardens use insecticides to get rid of pesky insects that they don't want. Unfortunately, these pesticides also kill the helpful insects like bumblebees at the same time. These pesticides can get trapped into pollen and nectar, making it even more likely that they will find their way to a bumblebee that is out collecting food. Finally, since they're so important to agriculture, people have begun keeping managed colonies of bumblebees to help out in their greenhouses. Unfortunately, these managed bee colonies often carry disease, which are then spread to the wild bees in the area. In North America, the decline of some species of bumblebees has been directly linked to the proximity of greenhouses using these managed bee colonies. Although the situation for bumblebees sounds bad, there's actually lots you can do in your own backyard. If you're interested in helping bees, check out the infographic by following the link in the description. And if you're a teacher, I've got free resources to help you incorporate more bees into your classroom with lessons on the science and math of bee conservation. Lessons on bees, not actual bees. If you like the video or learn something new, let me know in the comments and subscribe to get all the updates. Until next time, I'm Mr. Harris. Class dismissed.